Governor, what's your reaction to Jimmy Leotode, owner of Jimmy John's, saying that the corporate income tax is too much of a burden for his business and he's going to have to move out of the state? What's your reaction to that?
Well, I think you ought to rethink it. We're happy he's here. I don't know him personally, but he seems like a very hardworking fellow. But what I had to do last week is we had a fiscal emergency. I inherited a budget deficit of billions and billions of dollars when I became governor. I was direct right from the beginning. I said we needed to use the income tax to pay our bills, to pay the bills here at the university, to make sure that we have a great University of Illinois. And that's true all across our state. We had a $15 billion deficit, whatever it is, we have to deal with it. And I said so in the campaign, and I won the election, and we carried out what we had to do. It's a temporary income tax increase to 5% for individuals, 7% for corporations. Other states in the Midwest and elsewhere have higher corporate income taxes than we do. And also, we should point out that they have higher individual income taxes. The average in the Midwest and is about 5.7. So I think that we're having to do this to pay our bills. Ultimately, the tax rate after 4 years will go to 3.75. So I think that we have to, be honorable. We have to meet our obligations. People of Illinois believe in that. I think we believe in education and health care and public safety. And these bills, this deficit had mounted up long before I arrived. And my job is to be the repairman and clean it up and pay it off.
What do you plan to tell him to keep him here? Jobs are going to be lost in this community, Champaign, Urbana. What do you plan to say to him to try to keep him here?
Well, as I said, we created more jobs in Illinois this past year than any state in the Midwest. Illinois is a good market. If you want to have a good market, we have 13 million people in Illinois. They know how to work hard, and they enjoy going out and having opportunity to eat together. So to pass up this market, I think, would be a big mistake. We have some companies coming here. For example, Navistar is moving from Indiana to locate fully here in Illinois. Boeing is manufacturing in Metro East for the first time ever. Ford expanded, huge investment in Illinois. Fiat Chrysler just announced a $600 million investment in our state. We're the capital of the Midwest. Let's not sell ourselves short. Illinois is a strong state, in large part because we have great universities like the University of Illinois. We have a lot of good people, get well-educated here, and they make a difference here. So I'm not ever going to bum-wrap our state. We have the best of the best, and we always will.
What do you plan to do about the questions that Senator Culliton's raised about the appointments? Do you plan to reappoint those folks?
I think this is much ado about nothing, frankly. We appointed these people in the first place. They seem to think they have to be reappointed or temporarily appointed. We're not going to make a big deal out of that.
What are you going to do, though?
Well, the people I appointed, I'm going to take a look at all the names, and we have to make temporary appointments until they meet a week or two. We probably do that. But the bottom line is, for the next couple months, I'm going to be making large numbers of appointments to cabinet positions and sub-cabinet positions, other boards and commissions. We'll be acting very shortly on the appointments for the Board of Trustees of the University of Illinois. That's a very important thing I've done. I think we had a problem here that came up in 2009, and I appointed new trustees, and they, I think, carried out the reforms that I wanted and the people wanted, and those are the kind of people I'm looking for all across state government.
Do you plan to drop the ball at all by not acting on those earlier appointments over the past couple of years?
They've been sitting there for a long time. I wish they did act on the appointees, but they didn't, and so now they say you have to send the same names in, or give reappointments, temporary appointments, whatever it is. I just don't think this is a big deal.
Do you plan to reappoint the state police director as well?
Well, he's a good man. I think we should understand that John Munkin graduated with honors from West Point. He's a real leader. He went to Iraq. He served there. 100 tank missions, not one piece of equipment lost, and not one soldier lost. That's a real hero, an all-American hero. I have a great deal of confidence in John Munkin, and I don't want anybody I think, diminishing his excellent record in the military and also in the state police.
So is that a yes? Would you reappoint him?
Well, we're gonna. I'm gonna be looking at all of the people in state government that serve in various agencies. You'll hear plenty about that over the next few weeks and months.
Ready to start this tour?
No. Okay, one last question.
Are you going to reappoint the trustees who are in the University of Illinois trustees?
We'll have an announcement on there very shortly.